Imagine if we danced with Earth, watched her trail, sun, and flowers. Watch the storms and showers, too. The cracks in the earth, the screams of the waves. Know that she is not a force to exploit, but a being that is under no obligation to behave. Imagine if we lived alongside her, dined with her, admired her, saw her beauty and ferocity as not opposing, but composing someone, something, however you view it, worth preserving. But instead we subjugate cattle prods and electric fences, beaten down and ravaged, but by no means defenseless. Tell me, do you feel the heat rising? Can you hear the sea crying? Nothingness into the air that can render a city bare. Can you hear her tanks rumbling, grumbling, trumpeting, creating craters? Can you hear the screams of us, those of us breathing in the oxygen that feels her poison, and the sea stirred by her wrath? Can you see that the jilted bride is on the war path?
This is the future we're racing towards. A future that is harsh, a future that is unkind, a future where tensions are as high as the temperatures around us. How long will it take our society to mimic an iceberg and... We're facing issues of inequality and oppression now. Could you imagine how drastically that would increase in our future? How are we supposed to equitably distribute our dwindling resources? How did we get here? We're told as children that not everything we do is a race, but what are we supposed to do now that our planet is racing towards its sixth mass extinction in its history? Are we expected to just sit patiently and watch it pass us by?
Thank you.
strides, from California's pushback on emission standards to the reason we're here today, but there is much work to be done. Educating our next generation to be climate literate is an amazing and necessary task, but it can't end there. What if we push them to be climate creative? Climate creativity asks us to take a deeper look at the problem. It asks us to rethink our structural systems that are inherently harming the Earth because of the way they were designed. Climate creative students bring the necessary empathy, collaborative efforts, and imaginative minds needed to solve this climate issue. These qualities, teamed up with literacy, can make this next generation a force to be reckoned with.
To be on the land of the Tongva. I'd like to thank all for your continued dedication and support to climate change and the healing of Mother Earth. You may be aware that Channel Island sits on sacred Chumash land. Chumash legend says that the island of Limu became very overcrowded, and the Earth Mother Hutash decided to build a rainbow bridge to alleviate the overcrowding. She told the people, as you travel to the mainland, do not look down. You will become very dizzy and fall into the ocean and perish. Well, as the people started their way to the mainland, some of them did look down and they did fall into the ocean. But Hutash could not imagine her people perishing. So as they hit the water, Hutash turned them into dolphins. The Alakoi, the dolphin, is the protector of Cal State Channel Islands. And also, it is the mascot that reminds us that we must take care of each other. We must embrace each other. We must work for the better good. Also, at Channel Islands, we have a sacred mountain, that overlooks the university, that protects us, of Sa'wiwa, the bluffs, that reminds us of our shared connection and responsibility to watch over the land, the water, the winged ones, those who crawl the ground, the two-legged, everybody, all are respected and embraced.
At Cal State Channel Islands, we are working to strengthen our connections with Indigenous peoples, letting the Chumash values of stewardship of the lands and the waters and the creatures that inhabit them guide us toward advancing a more sustainable future. Our university community inches closer to this vision every day in actions big and small, from policy and practice to culture and civic engagement, as we assume collective responsibility for the stewardship that has been entrusted to us by those who came before and is promised to those who have yet to arrive. Previous generations may have paved paradise and built a parking lot, but our students are asking us to become the climate creative leaders that we need to realize a more just and equitable future for us all. Take it away, PJ.